Hello, dudes and dudettes, and welcome back to Murder at Soul Suspect. We last left off. We were continuing our journey out of the museum. Learned some interesting things on Baxter. He might actually be connected to this case more than we had thought to begin with. So, let's just find our way out of here.
Tex, did you hear something else happen just now? Something bad.
Someone told me about a murder.
No, like this just happened. Police are all freaking out.
What happened?
I don't know. Sounds serious, though.
This whole place is bad news. Have a bad feeling about tonight.
Dang it, you're not gonna tell us, are you? I wonder if something happened to Baxter. Alright. I need to find my way out, but... What am I freaking out about? The train's not moving, buddy. It's not gonna be moving. Let's see, can I teleport on the other side? I guess not. Oh well. Oh, what is this? Court records. I don't know how I didn't find that last time. Okay. Let's just find our way out of here. Can't go through here, that's annoying. Alright.
Did you see all those police lights?
I don't know. We came straight from a dinner in Boston. Maybe Jim knows.
So, I'm sitting there watching
the
Pats
game. Jim, did you hear
anything
about a crime or something?
What? Crime? No, I didn't hear anything.
Oh, yeah. It was by that old rundown apartment building. I guess some drug thing got busted or something. I never liked that street anyway.
Sheila was just saying there were police lights flashing and a street blocked off.
It might still be talking about our murder. But I can't really be sure. What the heck is this thing? Have I not explored this part of the museum yet? I guess not, because there's still a stone here. Still a stone left unrevealed, turned. Whatever. I guess I can't teleport through that stuff either. That's pretty annoying. Whoa, boy. That was close. Almost walked blindly right into that. Ooh. Hello. Museum date. Aw. Just need one more. It's just how it's gonna go every single time. It's gonna make me so mad. Because now all I'm missing is one stone. One stone yet to be revealed. And I have no idea where it is. The train is over there, so probably nothing over there. Have I already talked to you?
Bright flash, and then... nothing.
You could have gotten hit by that train like I did a few episodes ago.
So
oh, hey, you look.
The train was so loaded down with ammunition, like we were a rolling bomb.
You could get dunked for gossiping?
Wow.
Well, I just found the last stone. Sweet. Alright, now I need to find out how to get to it.
Thank you.
Let's collect that. Jeez, there's so many things here. Alright, let's go ahead and collect this thing here. And poof. Completed the story, let's listen to it. Alright.
My husband and I stepped off the platform and onto the giant hissing locomotive. I remember looking back at our small town and thinking of all the happy memories we made there. But I was excited to start our new life in Salem. I must have dozed off because I was startled awake by the sound of screeching metal. And as the train came to a halt, all I could hear was the torrential rain pelting against the roof. I looked out the window. There was only darkness. Then came the brightest flash of lightning I had ever seen. When my husband left to inquire about the delay, a woman in the back of the train started screaming. We rushed over to her and asked her what was wrong, but all she could manage to say through her sobs was something about seeing the spirits of the dead wandering in the rain. Stranger still were the passengers that were suddenly stricken with the painful memories of their past. It was at this point that I became truly terrified, so I set out to find Joe. When I reached the cab and still hadn't found him, I was worried. I looked out the front window and saw the train's conductor laboring to move a downed tree from the tracks. And there was Joe, walking up to help. However, instead of grabbing hold of the tree, Joe bent down, picked up a rock, and crushed the conductor's skull with it. When I left the train and ran up to him, I could see that this wasn't the Joe I once knew. Something had taken hold of him, something angry. Then he saw something that terrified him. He dropped the rock and ran off into the woods. However, right before he disappeared into the trees, during a bright flash of lightning, I thought I saw something chasing him, hunting him. I can only describe it as a ghostly specter, cloaked in black. But more likely than not, it was just a shadow. The authorities spent days combing the woods for Joe, but he never turned up. I tried to go back home, but the memories were too painful. Some nights I lie in bed, tortured by the thoughts of what our life could have been if we had never stepped onto that train.
Jeez. These tales are so haunting. Dang. Okay. Let's just get out of here. Now that I learned a little bit more about this train, I don't want to stay in here anymore. There we go. Alright, wrong door. Next door. There we go. Alright, let's get out of this place.
Why the hurry, boys? Where are you headed? Oh, no, no.
We're not headed to the church, are we? Alright. Oh man, we have to go to the church. We better step on it. Oh, hey, what's this? To the church. Oh, this way. Oh, what's this? 9 more! 9 more of these little things left. Wow. We're never gonna find them all. Oh, wow. I guess they're putting us on the way that the last two of them are. We might actually be able to find them. That's pretty cool. Have an episode pretty much dedicated to these little stories. Because I don't think I'm ever going to find any others. Why is this plaque randomly here?
Not going that way.
Okay, not going that way. Right, it looks creepy just for us, too. 6 more. Woo! Yay! Getting so excited. Ah, darn it. It's in the way. Alright, let's see, is there anything over here? Nope. Wow, they didn't put a thing over here. That's actually surprising. Would have been a great place to put one of those things. Maybe I took a wrong turn? Oh, what's this? Okay. I've been down here, haven't I? Yeah, I think this is like where it all began. Or maybe not. Whatever. Let's keep on going. Remove those. What's this picture doing here? Who is seeing Nelson? What's the point of this room? I mean, sure, this looks a bit creepy. Maybe? I'm not sure. It's definitely not soothing. Kitty! You're gonna help me out here, kitty. Kitty, kitty. Kitty! Come on, jump up the thing. There we go. Jump. Get up here. Alright. Ooh. Kitty certainly is not afraid of anything right now. Hey, lady.
Miss. What happened here? That looks like a baby down there.
Please help me. It's supposed to be dead. I can still feel growing inside me. It's trying to rip its way out.
Wait. You did this? You killed your own kid?
You don't understand. There was something wrong with it. It wasn't human. It was something else. Something darker.
What the hell are you talking about?
It showed me things. Horrible things. This was the only way to stop them from happening. But I was too late. They've already begun. I can see them crawling their way up from the flames. We have to run!
Find a way to move on. That seems like the best alternative.
You can't run from this. If you want it to stop, you have to find a way to move on.
I can't. There's nowhere to go. There's only darkness and flame.
Okay. Where'd the kitty go? There it is. Alright, have to find a way off this thing. How can I get off? Pretty sure kitty wants to get out too. Don't you, kitty? Yeah. Alright, come on. Let's find a way to get out of here. I guess kitty's stuck here. Well, you can find your own way down, kitty. Ooh, there's shortcuts. That's cool. You can open up the doors. Oh, what is this?
Oh, those street brawls. It's amazing I lived as long as I did.
Huh. Oh, wow. I found all of his little stories. Amazing. I didn't really expect I'd find all of many things at all. Alright. Maybe there's a door in here. There's not a door in here. Alright, let's continue on to the church. I've wasted enough time messing around with all this stuff. Yep. Alright, so. Let's keep on moving. I've already seen that. Oh, hey, there's a guy up there. Hello, sir. I swear, if there are demons out now, I might be a little bit annoyed. Nope, nothing around here. Can I teleport all the way down there? Ah. Dang it, doesn't look like I can. That would have been pretty cool. Alright, let's keep on going. Oh, maybe there's something over there worth looking at, maybe? Nope, nothing. I don't know why I can't teleport. Okay, let's keep on going to the church. Let's enter the church.
Cops and criminals get used to red and blue flashing lights. Even after you get numb to them, sometimes they still chill your bones. You can get that feeling that this time, they mean something personal.
Oh no, what happened? Okay, well, we know she's safe.
No, no, Joy, Joy, don't! Damn it.
At least she left the door open. I guess we rubbed off on her a little bit, made her a little bit more considerate.
Lieutenant, caught her sneaking up the side staircase. Says she's a friend of the priest.
Where's Father McCauley? Is he all right?
Just put her in my car. I want to interview her myself. Can somebody remind Broyles that the door's not going to watch itself?
Yes, sir.
It's a simple question, please!
Take it easy on her.
Hey, anybody find Baxter yet?
Nope. Went to the station, drove by his place, nothing. You know, there's definitely something wrong here.
I mean, honestly, have you ever seen anything like this?
Half this stuff feels like a goddamn riddle.
I don't know. I just seem so demented.
Demented. I gotta find this crime scene before they cart away all the evidence.
All right, find out what happened at the church. Joy and Iris are at the church. I need to make sure they're okay. Well, we know Joy is fine. We just saw her. Iris might be a different story. And we will continue on later to find out what is happening here next time. But for right now, please like and favorite, please share with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe on your way out, the Cyberwolf of Cyberwolf Games, signing off.